Welcome to the Season Week. Also, your comments, your questions on another edition of The Inbox. All next on Live. And now, here are Kelly Ripa and Mark Consuelo.
September 25th, 2024.
It's over. September is over.
Well, not yet. Not yet.
We're creeping
up. One more week.
That was fast.
September. I know.
Next thing you know, pumpkins are out.
You know.
Decorations are out.
I'm debating about.
Yes, tell me.
Halloween this year.
Please tell me.
Because there's a lot of. What is that? Is that spooky? Is that spooky Halloween music? There's a lot of construction this year on our street.
Right.
And I was thinking about not decorating the house.
I can get behind that.
I know. For Halloween. We're talking about Halloween.
Yeah. I think you're right. There's a lot of stuff happening. Yeah, and guess what? We don't have any kids living in our house anymore.
No, I understand that, but there's other people's kids that enjoy, you know.
Yeah, I don't care about other people's kids.
Yeah,
I wish I did. I just don't.
I know. I know.
Guys, you know what I mean, right? They have their own house. You know what we should do? We should go old school this year.
What does that mean?
We should go out on Halloween.
Yeah. We should go out on Halloween?
Yeah, yeah, you and I.
And trick or treat?
And get soap.
Yeah.
And toilet paper.
And do what with
it? And like TP people's houses. And soap their windows. You never soaped anybody's windows?
No.
You never soaped anybody's windows?
Never.
Now, I'm not soaping the windows. It's like a prank. Egging people's houses and cars, I never did that. That's just disrespectful. But soap, it's soap. Do you remember that movie with Tom Cruise where he's playing a football player in Pennsylvania? What was that movie called?
All the Right Moves.
Oh, yeah, that was
great. And he gets mad at his coach and he TPs his house.
Yeah, I think they spray painted like.
But I think he
slurs on.
Oh, really? I thought he TP'd his house.
No, they did like a lot of bad stuff to the coach's house. Yeah.
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 All right.
But he did the least of it.
Right. I think he just TP'd and got in trouble for that. So don't soap people's houses. But you're really thinking about not decorating. I think that's a great idea.
I'm really debating it because of the amount of
stuff.
Construction.
Yeah, we could take a year off.
Maybe, I don't know. I'm thinking about it. Just, there's a lot of stuff.
Yes.
You know, it's right next door. It's on the other side.
Right.
It's across the street.
I'm with you.
The street seems like it has a lot going on.
Yeah.
It already seems like Halloween there, but like the bad kind.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Maybe we'll take a year off. And let's not even give out candy.
No. No.
What?
Now that's a bridge too far. I'm just thinking about like what I can do to the house to make it festive, but not all the stuff.
Yeah.
Because I don't know where to
put
the stuff.
Just put a pumpkin out front. Just a little pumpkin. Let's do the laser light show.
Let me tell you about this man. If it was up to this man, Halloween would never have happened.
It's just so messy.
Christmas never would have
happened. No, I like Christmas.
Never would have been Thanksgiving. It never
Thanksgiving,
would have...
I love Thanksgiving.
No, I know you love it. You arrive like an honored guest.
Yeah.
But you don't know how... you don't know how it happens or where... He just arrives and he's like, where did all this crap come from? And I was like, the crap fairy.
Hey.
Once again, the crap fairy swooped in with all her crap.
Hey, today is National Daughter Day.
We have the best.
Yeah, we have the best daughter. How to celebrate your daughters today.
Oh my gosh.
Keep paying their credit card bills.
Is that what it says? No.
Yep. It says keep paying their phone bills. No, it says do a father-daughter dance. Oh. I wish I could do that today. I like dancing with Lola. She's great. Read about admired daughters. Like the book, read a book about Little Women, The Diary of Anne Frank.
Read a book.
Let her take the lead, as if that's even a choice. A spa day. Anyway, if you have a daughter, give her a hug today. Tell your lover.
I know. I'm sad that our daughter is so.
We love you, Lola.
We can FaceTime.
Yeah, we'll FaceTime Lola.
We can't FaceTime her. She's in the recording studio.
Oh, she's working.
Okay, she's working.
Good.
We can't.
Good.
FaceTime.
Later. Why the fuss? Genetics. Picky eating has been linked to DNA.
That's really interesting.
Uh-huh.
Because I will say, I'm not going to name names, but I had 3 children. I nursed them all. 2 of them were great nursers.
Right.
And one
was not.
Was not. I'm not going to name names. But one of the 3, not a great nurser.
Right. And is a picky eater.
Grew up to be a picky eater.
Yes.
And not so much now.
Just a couple things. Right.
But like when said child was a toddler and a young person, foods could not touch each other. Foods.
He loved where they would.
Well, you know, it's one of the boys. Yeah, right. Let's narrow it down.
Yeah. He loved where, you know, you'd go to those.
When we went out west
to one of those ghost ranches. There was great shows in Arizona.
Like you'd a go out chuck there, wagon a chuck, dinner.
And you bring your little tray and it has the compartments. He loved that.
And that was the first. Do you remember? That was the first meal. Because I remember I showed up and they were like, there's going to be a chuck wagon dinner. And I was like, great.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's not going to eat anything. And because the food was separated, he ate everything. And then he asked for seconds. Mm-hmm. You remember that? And I was amazed that he wanted seconds.
And do you remember? And then he had a thing.
He wanted to go to like medieval times. Why? Because they gave you the food in with those separators. So I said to Mark, we got to get those plates that have separators on them.
Well, that's linked to DNA, so one of us is responsible for that. Now,
go for it.
Listen, I eat everything. There's not one thing. The only thing I don't like is tofu. And that's not even a real food. I eat everything. You, on the other hand, madame, don't like a lot of things. You don't like poultry? You won't eat anything with a beak. You won't eat anything with a beak.
I don't think that's unusual. I think there are many people
that don't like beaked
food.
That's not true. It's a weird thing. There are certain things you don't like. I think you're responsible for him being. I'm pointing the finger at you.
Well, since we're blaming families.
Hey, do you remember that one time? I asked him. Tomatoes are so great. We all love tomatoes. And I was like, I did one of those dad things from the 1950s. You're not leaving this table till you eat your tomato.
Oh, it was so bad. So bad.
I thought he was just being difficult. No, it's an actual aversion to tomatoes.
As a matter of fact, when I ate tomatoes, not to take it back to nursing, when I ate tomatoes when I was nursing, he would not latch on. It was wild.
Yeah.
The pediatrician said, did you have tomatoes? And I said, yes, how did you know that? And he said, a lot of times babies have an aversion to tomatoes and they can somehow taste it in there.
Interesting.
I was like, what else is this kid tasting?
Tequila.
Don't be ridiculous.
Joke.
You want to burn more calories? Sure, we all do. Who doesn't want to burn more calories? Climbing stairs. Climbing stairs is the most effective exercise for losing weight and burning calories. Stair climbing as regular exercise. Or you can just add a few light stairs a day. That will
really
also I remember when I climbed to the top of the Empire State Building, and I really felt like I didn't do it for dietary reasons. We did it here as a challenge, you know, one of those stupid challenges that we like to do on the show. But I felt like I got a metabolism boost, like a weight loss that I wasn't looking for the entirety of that week and maybe a little beyond.
Yeah, climbing the stairs are great.
Because that was a really wild challenge.
Yeah, that was crazy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do you remember I came back from that and I
yeah, you like, were, I you're ready not, to do the next one.
But I could not satiate
no.
my own yeah. hunger. Like I was
it's good
hungry
for you.
From that.
It's really, really good for you.
Mm-hmm. But they're saying it's you burn 20 times more calories going upstairs than walking on flat ground.
You know, I'm at the age where now going downstairs is weird.
It's terrifying.
It's just weird. It's yeah. like my ankles aren't flexible enough to, and my knee, I mean, it's a strange feeling.
Do you know where I have particular trouble?
Tell me.
With going down the stairs? Hmm. At the dentist office.
Oh, well, those are steep.
Oh, those are...
But those are, they're shallow stairs, or I don't...
Yeah, but it's also very narrow and...
And it turns.
Yeah. But I feel like even my, I don't have large feet, but maybe large for my size. But I don't think my feet are particularly large.
The treads are small.
But I feel like the treads are small. And I think about, you have large feet, so I think about you going down. You must walk down sideways. You must, when you're in skis,
no, I do like
walking
the little kids.
Down.
I go down backwards on my knees.
You scoot down.
Hey, listen, Helene, yes. Close to hurricane strength. Winds could hit 120 miles per hour before the Florida landfall, and it's going to hit. Is it going to hit tomorrow? Is that what's happening?
Thursday, yeah.
Thursday. All right.
And
so be
what
careful.
Part of Florida
That's
is
the panhandle?
It?
Yeah.
Yeah, northern, right around the curve. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. So be careful, guys.
Yeah, be careful for sure.
Yeah.
This is going to make you very excited, Mark, because I know how much you love this. When our kids used to play with these, but. Gen Z has declared love for the Tamagotchi. They are bringing back the Tamagotchi.
Oh, yes.
The fashion keychain, knickknack, used to go on my kids' backpacks.
Mm-hmm.
It was $20.
What did it do?
I don't know. Somehow you would keep it alive.
Kept it alive. It, you entertained it. You walked it. Yeah.
Our kids did none of that. We just threw them away.
Do you remember the Furby?
Yes. Oh, please. Yes.
Remember when you murdered the Furby?
I may put it outside.
He put it outside.
I put it outside.
And it coughed to death. I'm not kidding. He threw the Furby in the backyard.
It wouldn't stop.
And this is what we heard.
It wouldn't stop.
Through our window at night.
Cold.
I'm not kidding.
It just wouldn't stop. It wouldn't stop making noise.
And I would sit in bed at night, and I would say to him, it's dying out there. He's like, it's not dying. The battery's dying.
I just got
a flashback.
I just got a flashback.
Yeah. There's the Furby, the beloved Furby. Yeah. You really hated that toy.
I'm a monster.
Basically a monster. Hey, we've got a huge show today. Shailene Woodley is here.
And we continue forward to the season week with tips on beating the fall blues. A real thing.
Gosh,
we
yeah.
need this right now.
It's a real thing. And we've been feeling more
tired. We've been feeling
tired.
It and kind of like...
Blah,
yeah, Sunday blah, scaries. Blah.
Yeah, Sunday scaries.
Yeah, I'm glad. I'm glad we're doing that.
Yeah. All right. It's the moment you've all been waiting for. It's time to play.
Okay. Let's say hello to Brenda Cameron from Northern Cambria, Pennsylvania, who watches the show on WTAE. She says she wants to stump me so she can beat me at my own game.
Mm.
All right, Brenda. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. How are you two?
Hey, that's a beautiful photo. What lake are you on?
That is Lake George, New York.
Ah, it's great.
Nice.
It's beautiful. It gets so clear, You can follow your anchor clear to the bottom.
Wow. That's amazing. All right, listen. Brenda, you know how this game works. You've given me two statements. One is true, one is false. I have 60 seconds to figure out which is the truth. And if you stump me, you'll win this. And that. All right, here are Brenda's two statements.
I always look up as though the prize might change.
Here are your two statements. I was a competitive barrel racer as a kid, or I saw wolves while snowmobiling in Yellowstone.
Wow.
Is that Gelman, that's a plausible thing, right? You can see wolves in Yellowstone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
How many wolves did you see?
Yeah, how many wolves?
Okay, we spotted two wolves. Actually, when you go in Yellowstone, you have to go with a guide. And, we were behind the guide on our sled, and we saw these two wolves, and the guide went one way, because my husband and I were on a two-up sled, and we went the other way, and we got to see these two beautiful wolves. Gorgeous.
What color?
The one was kind of multicolored, and the other one was a white one.
Wow. Very, very cool. Tell me about barrel racing. Tell me about
that.
Well,
I was competing in 4-H when I was a kid. I was always around horses. And I had a paint horse that was pretty fast. So I did the 4-H program, barrel racing, and you're timed how fast you go around the barrels, how close you go without bumping them. And
yeah,
it was fun. We did good. I mean, it wasn't like I was any, you know, high awards or anything, but I had fun at it.
Yeah, I was going to ask you a few more questions, but time ran out.
Oh.
Well, is there one question that you had?
Well, did you start with the left barrel or the right barrel?
What do you mean? You start at the one end and you just go loop around them from one end to the other.
Okay. See, I know.
You know what?
I know about barrel racing.
How do you know about barrel racing?
There are three barrels. And you either go right or you go left, and you have to do a clover leaf thing. You can choose if you want to go right or left.
Are you sure that's accurate? Or did you just Google that?
And then once you get to the end of going around the barrels, you come as fast as you can back. And that's where you gain your time.
Here's what I think. I think you saw wolves while snowmobiling in Yellowstone.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
We should take Mark's Google machine away from him. He shouldn't be allowed to Google these things.
I didn't tell whether he was telling the truth or not, you know, so.
Yeah. I just was getting clues.
Mm-hmm.
All right, listen, I'm sorry. You didn't win the mug or the t-shirt. I'm a monster. But you still have a chance to win a valuable trip. It's time for Great Getaways Travel Trivia.
Phyllis Spencer from Bronx, New York.
That was great.
That's a chic outfit, too.
Ooh, thank you.
You look amazing.
Courtney Washington from Brooklyn.
Yeah, looking good. All right, shout out to Courtney Washington from Brooklyn for that great design. Deja, spin the wheel and see what else Brenda's playing for. All right. Okay, you're playing for a trip for two to the Vidanta Los Cabos in Mexico. 7 days and six nights. It includes three meals daily, access to the Reserve Club. It's a prize valued at $17,500. You have 20 seconds and only one guess. Brenda, good luck.
Okay, here we go, Brenda. Earlier this week, we talked with Jay Farrow. What did Jay say was the name of the teacher he would do an impression of when he was 8 years old?
That is so hard.
That is really hard. Ten seconds.
Miss Banco.
Wow!
expeditions, you and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at Vidanta Los Cabos. This luxurious resort offers the perfect setting for upscale relaxation, showcasing incredible dining and stunning views of the Sea of Cortez, beautiful pools with shaded cabanas and lounge beds, indulgent spa offerings, and a golf course. Plus, Vidanta Los Cabos is home to the one-of-a-kind Reserve Beach Club and restaurant. Your prize is valued at approximately $17,500.
Wow. Congrats.
Brenda, that was... how in the world? I was here, and I don't remember that.
I don't know.
Great job.
I think my husband helped me.
Good. Great, you should take him to Mexico with you.
Yeah, take him. Please take him with you.
All right, Brenda. Now you get to make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive a Typhoor Dome air fryer valued at approximately $500. So please pick a number between 1 and 136.
Well, I'll go with 24 because yesterday was my husband's birthday.
All right. Don't go away. We'll be right back with more of the show.
Still ahead on Live, we continue Fall Into the Season Week with tips.
LJ Wilson.
Tomorrow's show, Niecy Nash will be here, and Fall Into Fashion Season Week continues with tips for getting your skin ready for winter.
Oh, no.
Yes, it's
not
coming.
Winter.
It's coming.
I feel like I just summarized my skin.
The transition from summer to fall can sometimes bring a change in energy levels and mood, so here to help us prioritize a little more self-care to beat the fall blues is Dr. Gail Saltz. Hey, Dr. Saltz.
Hey, Dr. Saltz, always the most important guest we have on this show.
What
is it about fall that sucks the life out of us and makes us so sad?
That's a long haul. A couple of things. Shorter days and less sunlight means that melatonin, we're circadian beings, right, starts to kick in and rise earlier, which makes us feel tired and sluggish. And it actually, as melatonin rises, it causes cortisol to go down, which de-energizes us. So we feel kind of blah. And the less light can really affect our mood. But also, fall is associated with the end of summer, which is a loss psychologically for a lot of people, right? No more barbecues, no more vacations, no more family getting together, no more fun in the sun at the beach. And that feeling can create a dread, a feeling of like...
That's exactly what I feel.
A dread.
Dread.
And the dread is also like... The leaves are changing, and you like that, right?
Yeah.
But that means they're dying, and that means winter's coming.
Right.
And that sense of dread can really affect our mood. And also, it is a stressful time, right? Kids go back to school, your work ramps up, and that increased stress can really affect our mood. And this season, election stress is causing a lot of people.
Exactly.
The discord, all of us are affected by that.
Okay. So what are the signs if we're suffering from fall blues?
So it can look different for different people. So pay attention if you do feel sluggish and tired and have trouble getting up to do the things you would normally be doing. Pay attention if you're feeling sadder and just more low mood. But also pay attention if you're feeling irritable and cranky during the day, because that can be a different kind of presentation, but can also be fall blues.
That's you. You're cranky.
Okay. What exactly can we do to beat the blues?
Okay, so first of all, I want to say you want to change the associations that you have right now of loss to something that you look forward to and enjoy.
It's football season.
Okay, that's a great one.
Yes.
So you know you want to maybe even record the game and look forward to showing yourself a little football every night for 20 minutes.
Oh.
You want to have something a little in the morning and a little in the evening.
Yes.
That you look forward to. Okay, maybe.
Say more.
He can't possibly watch more football. We've run out of hours
in the day. You can spread it out.
Okay.
But, like, get up in the morning, play your favorite music while you're having your coffee. coffee or put your coffee in a to-go cup and go for a walk outside where you're in nature.
We should do that. Yes.
Look forward to things.
Yeah. What else do you recommend?
Okay. Very important. We think of light box and light therapy associated with winter blues, but really this starts in the fall. So if this is becoming you, start treating yourself now. Mm. So we have some light boxes here. These are therapeutic light boxes. That means they have 10,000 lux of light. Yours is up top there. The switch, exactly. And mine is here.
Whoa. Oh.
Okay, super bright.
Yeah.
Because it's 10,000 lux of light.
Okay.
And you want to place this so that it's looking at your face, but you're not staring at it. With your eyes open, about 12 inches from your face, for about 50.
Đâu để thử kim mới kìa. Thử kim mới nè. Ui. Chưa kịp nói tiếng người luôn đã đầu thai rồi. Trời ơi. Trời ơi. Trời đất cư. Nhẹ tự quánh chị hả hả? Nhẹ. Trời ơi. Đó cho đánh lén. Cho mày đánh lén. Cho mày đánh lén. Cúp thiền mới được. Ủa nhớ thiền của mình á. Phải không? Đâu phải. Rồi mình đi cúp thiền qua cái đảo bên kia các bạn ơi. Ê, ê quên. Để lấy tiền cái. Tiền bên đây mà không lấy đừng có nói cái gì á. Ê cái con này nãy đánh mình nãy phô. Thấy ghét quá chém nó coi. Chém nó. Ừ biến mất luôn. Thì ghê chưa. Biến mất luôn. Rồi qua bên kia. Cái trình bên đây là không có. Không có. Trời ơi, xin chay. Lên. Để qua chém cái con này coi. Đó. Đó, chạy. Nó đấm. Đấm, chạy. Có đấm không? Không đấm chết tiếp. Ừ, chạy. Rồi chạy không nổi luôn. Vô để hồi phục cái. Hồi phục cái lại mình chém nó nữa nha. Từ từ đợi cho hồi phục cái. Từ từ. Đầu. Mày gian quá. Mặt gian quá. Trời. Ê. Rồi chạy. Nó chạy rồi. Chạy không nổi rồi. Ơi thử coi. Thử trái này coi. Ê, rồi xong luôn. Bye bye luôn.